Thank you, Amber and Madeline and Josh, for joining us today at Iron Butterflies Project Open Wings program. We're delighted to have you today. I'd like for you to introduce yourself a little bit and tell us a little bit about how you got involved in Joshua Stage.
My name is Amber, and I got involved with Joshua Stage because I was one of my professors at UT suggested it to me, and so I was very volunteering.
I'm Madeline. I'm in an individual differences class because I'm a theater education major, and in our class, Joshua came in who's a guest speaker and like talked about the program, and like I absolutely love theater, so immediately I was like, this is what I want to do. Like, I want to do this project.
I'm Josh Durkin. I met Joshua through a client that I used to work for, and I raised my two little brothers from when I was 8 years old until they were probably 16. And they had severe ADD. I've worked with special needs kids since high school, and he needed a music director, and this just kind of worked out. So
what are your roles here at Joshua Stage?
So I run the music department of Joshua Stage. I make sure we've got music going all the time, we've got a guitar, and I try to teach kids that you can get socially interactive through music, that you can work together, make sure that there's a mutual beneficial outcome for every song. You can work together, make something better, and it helps teach social skills and working together.
Okay, thank you.
Most of what we do is like we really try and make sure that the kids are like staying involved and that they're on track and like that they're staying focused and that they're really like getting something out of this and like having fun.
So do you teach a specific class or?
No, we just kind of help run the overall
organization.
Like, organization.
Okay. And Amber?
It's the same.
The same kind of thing?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. And so tell me about the creative outlet method. That seems like a very unusual approach, and I know that Joshua created him himself. And how does that work for you all?
So the goal of the creative outlet method is to make sure kids, a lot of special needs kids have trouble integrating with other kids with special needs. They just can't sometimes, their disabilities don't let them socially interact. So the creative outlet method helps them break down those barriers. And we do that through theater arts and crafts, music, all of that. That helps kids interact with each other and also become more confident in themselves.
Okay. Have y'all had any experience with that? Does that help at all in your interactions?
Oh, definitely. I mean, like a lot of the kids would really struggle, and then as soon as we are like, okay, well, we're gonna make puppets today. We're gonna do like a puppet show, and then they'll like immediately like it helps them like really get involved, and then they like start connecting with other students and like working, and it's just really great.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and it's really interesting to see that like certain kids respond differently to certain like creative, you know, outlets. Like some really are into music, and some are really into like the arts and crafts section. And it's really just, it's so great to like see kids kind of like come out of their shells for like whatever their favorite activity is, that like they just like connect so like deeply with that.
So have you any success stories? Have you had any child that really surprised you in how she or he acted? Like maybe when they got here, and maybe how after a few weeks or months they changed or evolved?
Oh yeah, we've got one who came in and was quite rough running around, and as he's gotten with the program, understood the rules, now he's calm, he's sitting there, he's participating, and he's really enjoying the stuff that he's really into arts and crafts, he's really blossoming there. It's really nice to see that. Mm-hmm.
Anything else? Anybody else stand out? Like when they do their productions or any surprises?
It's really most of them. You get to see all of them in some way or another blossom and become just like a better version of themselves. It's really wonderful. You can just see them. They put on a costume or they make something nice in arts and crafts, or they really enjoy a song and they just become this higher version of themselves. It's really wonderful.
And so you mentioned the rules. So how do the rules work? And how
so
they help?
We've got a system called the HIP rules. The H stands for hey, hey, what? So if I say hey, everyone says hey, what? And then they have to listen to us. Then we have I, which is for I am making good decisions. So we want to make sure the kids that are, they're not hitting, punching, they're doing stuff that has beneficial outcomes for everyone. And then the first P is positive words, and the second one's positive actions. And so that makes sure that every kid is doing things that are positive for both themselves and other kids.
So how has that affected how they interact?
We started that about, I think it was 2 months ago, we came up with those rules, or Joshua did. Mm-hmm. And it's really worked. We can just say, hey, remember, positive actions, and then they, like, you can tell that there's a mental thought. They think back to seeing that poster board and the rules, and then like, oh, okay, maybe I shouldn't do that. That's not a positive thing to do.
And you have a new way of applauding, right? There's a special way to clap and applaud.
We do. After every activity, you go, do it with me, ladies. You go right hand up, left hand up, cross them in front, pat yourselves on the back, round of applause.
So nobody can be sad after that.
Yeah.
No, it's funny. Some of the kids, if we forget to do it, if it's an incredibly hectic day, they actually get mad. They're like, we didn't applaud. It's pretty cute.
That's good. Well, so is there anything else that you would like to share with our readers and viewers about your experience? It's only been in existence a few months. So you all have had many, many, many students go through, and you've had a lot of successes. So is there anything that you're looking forward to in 2018?
For me, this is the most fulfilling thing I've ever done. I've worked with special needs kids since high school, and it's really wonderful just because I don't think of this as a job. I get to come in and hang out with kids and make them laugh and like see them grow every single day. It's wonderful for me. So I hope 2018 we get to do more of that. That's what I want, every single day.
Okay, good. Well, thank you.
I know for me, like, it was originally just a class requirement, but I absolutely love this. Like, I love getting to come here every week and get to, like, work with these kids because they're all so great and so sweet, and it's definitely something that I, like, look forward to continuing.
Yeah. That is the same way with me because I started coming here for a class, but I, like, since I've been here, like, I really enjoy it, and I'm, like, looking forward to finding, like, other, like, volunteer opportunities with this, like, program that I can, like, fit in my schedule and, like, keep coming.
Any advice for parents who are trying to decide if this is the right place to bring your children?
Yes.
You have some advice?
Yes.
what would that be?
Yeah.
Sign up, do it, your advice is to do it.
Just do it. What's the worst that can happen? Okay. Your kid finds that he loves fine arts.
That's good.
Well, thank you all so much. I appreciate your time. I know you're getting ready to go into the playroom and work with your students. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.